Hi everyone, this is Asaf and you're watching part 2 of my sparring session with Tom. Like in the previous video, we reset in open guard and I try to pull him with my hooks, while Tom tries to step in and take the inside position in order to start trying to pass my guard. Tom gets the inside position and starts working his X pass and his slice combos. I'm able to re-guard by framing and swinging my outer leg over. Here Tom clears my legs with an X pass, but only pushes my knee backwards instead of backwards and away. So through framing on Tom's hips, I create the space I needed to swing my outer leg. Had Tom pushed my legs away as well, my hips would have faced the other way, negating my ability to swing my leg over. While swinging my leg, I kept my near side knee behind Tom's thigh, which allowed me to continue my swinging motion and get my outer leg inside Tom's legs and establish cross-ashigarami position. After getting my leg inside, I based on my elbow and scooted my hips away to expose Tom's heel. Tom does a good job grabbing my neck, which would have let him climb back to top position, but I was able to strip the grip and secured my position. I went for the heel but felt like my position was loose because Tom was pushing my thigh and separating my legs. In order to solidify control and get our hips close, I let go of the heel hook and establish control on the secondary leg. After establishing control, Tom rolls away and gets his knee past my knee line and escapes my attack. We then reset with me in top position and Tom playing butterfly guard and move to the center of the mat. When I start passing an opponent in an open guard situation, I like to probe their guard by carefully inserting my foot without committing too much weight to it. I see how they respond and I act accordingly. Here I can see Tom's hunting for the shin to shin, so I distract him with grip fighting before I step in, which prevents him from controlling my leg with his arm and getting the shin to shin position. I step inside and Tom has one leg on my hips, so he tries the tripod sweep. I counter by turning my far foot towards Tom and high stepping backwards to base again. Since Tom was fighting hard for my arm, I took advantage of that and got control of his head. I close the distance and I start attacking my pass. Here we're in a loose guard half guard position and I threaten with a guillotine choke. This is not a high percentage guillotine in my experience, but it's a great way to set up the darts choke when your opponent tries to peel away your choking arm. He'll usually try to peel it away with his top arm, so I release the guillotine, pull that arm and sink in a deep darts. Here you can see my guillotine arm control Tom's wrist, but Tom manages to get his head out and we end up back in half guard with Tom having his knee shield. I go back to open guard and I get my knee inside Tom's hip socket. From here I usually backstep pass by getting a reverse underhook on the far side, but in this case I try to get my knee across Tom's waist so I could spin into the cross ashigarami position. However, Tom went to the elbow push escape and opened his legs, which forced me to backstep and pass the guard. In most cases, the elbow push escape would have forced me to retreat. But since Tom's wrist was above his shoulder, I was able to collapse his arm and get the pass. I transition to knee on belly and Tom tries to elbow escape. I take advantage of that to work my handshake grips, but Tom attempts a Granby roll, so I make sure to keep my grips and connect my chest to his back. I try to go for a triangle, but I feel that Tom's elbow is close to his body and I won't be able to get it, so I get back and start working my crucifix game. I separate Tom's elbow from his body and swing my leg to capture Tom's arm and roll into the crucifix. In the crucifix, I like to threaten with the double combination of one arm rear naked choke and the crucifix armbar. This is probably the strongest combo I have. Tom does an excellent job throughout this exchange by keeping his chin tucked to his chest and holding my thigh with his trapped arm. Notice how Tom tries to hip escape in order to get his near knee under my legs, in order to trap them and pin my hips in place, which would allow him to hip escape. I try to counter by hooking Tom's hips with my legs and force them to face the other side, while still threatening with both the choke and the armbar. Tom finally wins this exchange and traps my near side leg, which is enough to let him turn into my crucifix, disconnecting his back from my chest. I try a last ditch Americana, but it's very low percentage and I let it go in order to maintain my far side motorcycle grip and go for my favorite deadlift armbar. Tom's been cut in the deadlift armbar enough times to see it coming, and now every time I try it, he rolls away lightning fast and it's really challenging to get him in it. We reset with Tom in top position and open guard. Tom decides to pass from his knees and I quickly set up my butterfly guard. We grip fight for a second and Tom tries to push me back through my head, I get a tricep grip and a head grip of my own and use them to butterfly sweep him. Tom gets a knee between us, so I start working floating passes. Specifically, I'm trying to hook his ankle with my other leg. I'm trying to push his leg back and fall into mount, but he frames on my hips and prevents that and tries to get the single leg X position. I then grip his head to establish control and hip switch to clear the knee, but Tom kicks his leg away and manages to trap my leg and face me. I push his knee back and control his top leg in order to secure a triangle on his legs and start attacking his leg. First, I grip Tom's leg with my primary arm, as close to me as possible, then I switch grips to hold the leg with my secondary arm to allow me to punch my elbow back to secure the heel for the heel hook. I close the gable grip and exert finishing pressure by extending my hips and tilting my torso sideways to get the tap. We reset again in open guard and Tom goes for his knee slice knee fold combo. When he goes for the knee fold, I maintain my butterfly hook, and when he tries to pass towards my back, I elevate him, switch my hooks and use his momentum to sweep him. Notice I couldn't just sweep him sideways but had to go 180 degrees before I could break him down. I start setting up my knee slice pass, but instead I staple one of his arms. He grips my staple leg and uses it together with his strong underhook to come up to his knees and try to sweep me. I counter by using a wizard to create strong downward pressure, forcing him to release my leg and base on the mat in order to create enough power to sweep me. Since my leg was free, I now try to threaten with a butterfly sweep, but Tom knee cuts over it, so I sweep him again to the other direction. I start going for the same guillotine darts combo, but Tom bridges towards me, almost sweeping me. I counter by staying tight and basing my leg on the mat, trying to continue with the guillotine darts attacks. Tom gets his back on the mat, neutralizing my darts, while I transition to knee on belly. I start threatening with the Americana, forcing Tom to turn away from me, exposing his back and arms to the handshake grips. I swing my leg over his legs for the modified S-mount, and Tom bridges into me to try and defend the armbar. I use my leg to push against his hips and start setting up the armbar. I wasn't able to pass my outer arm over Tom's head while still holding his arm, so I let it go and push his head to get my leg over, closing the armbar. My wrist grip made it impossible for Tom to connect his hands or otherwise defend the extension of his arm, and I got the tap. This is one of my favorite moments in our sparring. I'm passing from combat base, and like passing from standing, I probe with my leg, basing my weight on my arm. I see Tom trying to set up a single leg X entry, so I bait him into it, and when he goes for it, I circle my foot to his hip socket and drive all my weight forward to start passing. I almost lost balance, but managed to recover and stay close to Tom. I secure side control and go for the leg drag position, trying to work my motorcycle grip for the deadlift armbar. But Tom pushes my head and starts a Granby roll. With his leg on the other side of my head, I try to pass towards his back, but he frames on my hips, so I switch my hips and pass between his legs. I work to free my leg, but Tom hip escapes and try to get my back. I roll to get my back on the mat and avoid that, and Tom ends up in top position and start passing my guard. I use the reverse de la hiva to delay his knee slice and connect my hands in an S grip around his neck. I let him complete the knee slice in order to trap him in a NoGi baseball bat choke. The choke works best for me when I release the pinky of the hand behind his neck, which lets me generate way more choking pressure. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please let me know what was your favorite moment from our sparring in the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications to get my videos first.